Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, you'll learn how to apply refraction to 3D objects in action. For those of you who are not familiar with the concept, refraction refers to the way that light distorts as it passes through an object that has transparent or semi-transparent properties. I am referring to objects such as glass, plastic, ice, diamonds, and the list goes on. Each material has its own refractive properties, and you can now emulate this in the Flame 2020 products. Now, I do want to point out that Flame does not calculate full multi-bounce ray tracing. However, it's incredibly fast and works with a range of GPUs and not just the latest and greatest. So this is really clever tech, and it works on the Linux and Mac platforms of the Flame products. You may be very surprised how quickly and how great the results can be. This can be used on 3D models, 3D texts, 3D shapes, as well as regular image objects. If you'd like to follow along, please click the link in the description below to download the zip file. Alternatively, if you're watching the video podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. Now import the downloaded media into batch and connect it into the background input of a new action node. Double-click the action node for its controls and switch to a 2-up view with Alt-2. Have the result view on the right with F4, and you can use either the action schematic or the manager in the left viewport. The first step you're going to do is import some 3D geometry. Call up the contextual menu in the left viewport and choose Import. In the file browser, ensure the setting is set to FBX and navigate to the downloaded 3D model. Select the model and load it into the 3D scene. Now, this model is made up of a single geometry, and if you look at its materials, it's already been defined as a PBR model. So there is a shader node, which applied the physical base shading, and there is a material node, which controls the look of the object. Now, this model needs to be lit to see it correctly. You can add a 3D light, but for physical-based lighting, it is better to use an IBL. Select the camera, and through the contextual menu, choose to add an IBL node. The object is shaded and is using the background to light the glass. You can use any image you like as an IBL, but for this example, I want you to use a specific one to make this object clearly stand out. Double-click on the IBL map and go to the Read File menu. Choose Load and choose the emptylab.exr file. This applies a different kind of lighting on the glass, and we can go from here. Now, refraction is based on the material of an object and its transparency. So to start, select the glass geometry to call up its properties. In the geometry menu, you can start increasing the transparency. Please note that when you introduce semi-transparency with a 3D geometry, you will need to sort the polygons to have a proper rendered result. So click the pull-down menu and choose Sort All. This is an important step you must not forget. Now, transparency can be controlled from this menu. However, the material node has this functionality and is the recommended way of working. So set this slider back to 0% and choose to display the material node menu. You can define the texture color through the material menu, and you can also perform a light wrap through the light wrap menu. If you switch to the blending menu, here you will find blend modes, transparency, and refraction. The reason I recommend adjusting transparency here is that you can share a single material node across multiple geometries. So hundreds of geometries can have all their properties controlled through a single menu. Now let's start making this model look like glass. Set the transparency to 90%. This is a good start. However, if you start rotating the model on the x-axis, you can see that the lighting is working, but visually, the glass does not look correct because the background doesn't change as you look through the glass. This is where you should be seeing refraction. To enable this, the first value you need to set is the index of refraction. This is a mathematical measurement of refraction, and you can find all values online to mimic different materials. 1.0 means no refraction, and all you see is an undistorted background through the geometry. Now set the IRR value to 1.5. This is the refractive value for glass. If you wanted crystal, that's 2.0, and diamond is between 2.4 and 2.5. Values below 1 are not realistic, but they make an interesting effect. There are plenty of resources online, and you can look them up in your own time. If you start rotating the 3D model, you can see how quickly the glass effect has been achieved. The background is bending and refracting as you look through the glass. Any objects you put behind this 3D model will also refract. So this functionality is completely aware of the 3D environment. As a tip, if your geometry is not as clear as this, I recommend setting the material color to white for the best results. Now there are some additional settings under refraction, which give you added flexibility and creativity. For instance, if you have the correct index of refraction, but you'd like to push the effect even more, you can increase the intensity. This changes the result quite a bit. As a tip, this value can also cause the refraction to vertically flip, which is sometimes a natural refractive occurrence when looking through various liquids. Minimum thickness allows you to define the thinnest surface to be affected by refraction. You'll need this to apply refraction on a flat surface object. Now, not every refractive surface is totally clear like glass. I mean, you could want frosted glass, or perhaps you want to blow something out. So the roughness value in refraction will soften the result for a different look. Next, you will note that the 3D geometry has different thicknesses in different places. This affects refraction, but you can also force color to be affected. Under transmittance, you can set the colors for deep as well as shallow thicknesses. When you decrease the deep values, the thicker parts of the geometry will be affected by the chosen color first, and gradually spread out to the rest of the model. Alternatively, decreasing the shallow value will affect the thinner parts of the model and gradually spread out to the other areas. You can use a combination of both and create some very interesting color combinations of refracted light. Finally, dispersion refers to color dispersion through a refraction. If you increase the amount, it creates chromatic aberrations, which can also occur naturally through a refraction. So there is lots of scope to experiment and develop with refraction and physical-based rendering. Speaking about PBR materials, the Substance PBR library has also been updated with translucent materials that take advantage of refraction. To illustrate this, select both the shader and material node for the glass and delete them. You do this because the Substance PBR materials will add new ones. Select the glass 3D model, and through the contextual menu, add a Substance PBR map. In the browser, navigate to the translucent folder, and you will find 5 new materials that use refraction. Select glass clear as an example. You will need to select the material node again, and just set the transparency to 90%. When you rotate the model, you can see that the glass material has a slightly different feel to the previous one. If you select the Substance PBR map, you can play around with the inverted IOR and change the color. If you wanted to use all the other functions in the material node for refraction, they will still work with the Substance PBR map. Now, just to show you one more sample, select the Substance PBR map and switch to the texture menu. Change the preset and choose the ice texture. You can tweak the look of the ice, and if you select and rotate the model, you can see the types of looks you can achieve with these textures. Finally, it is also possible to customize your own PBR maps for refraction, and this is something to think about for the future. Now, as a reminder, there are multiple ways in which you could use refraction, and this is not limited to just imported 3D geometry. Think about 3D text, 3D shapes extended by cubic surfaces, and regular surface objects. Over the coming videos, you'll examine different scenarios where you'll be able to use this great functionality. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2020. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.